on this topic. It's not very firm positions, it's continuous conversations. And it is around one flagship project that I'm going to be presenting. I come from the CSI background. So the dilemma we've always had is, how do you draw the distinction between what is for social good and what is for commercialization? And should things that have been developed for social good be used for commercial purposes? This is an ongoing discussion we've had at Vodacom for a very long time. On one hand, the ethics and governance codes of Vodacom does not allow the foundation to be used for commercial purposes. But the strategy of the foundation is to use Vodacom's capabilities to deliver its processes. So that makes then the line to be very thin and to be very blurred as to how far can it go as a social good thing and whether it can be a commercial entity. As part of this discussion we have had, this is what the picture that is coming up, that it is possible that things can be developed from the needs by social entrepreneurs. And these things can come and reside within the Vodacom's products and services and can get to be developed as commercial offerings. We have positioned ourselves as the Vodacom Foundation as a test bed where some of the products can be used in management of HIV/AIDS. At this point, we are looking at which ones will be the most effective. We have started a project then of saying, let us use as many of these products as possible. We are developing this in the context of a very cluttered space in terms of there are many ICT solutions around there. There are many diverse needs within the health system, particularly in HIV/AIDS, and a vacuum in the policy or strategy of government. What we did then is to call upon most of the people we have worked with in the past. We have worked with these companies in different environments. They are all working within HIV/AIDS. But as a way of trying to consolidate them and scale them up, we call them together. We say, PRACHealth, you've been working with us on VLife. Geomed, you've been working with us on systems. Cell Life, you've been working with us on another system in HIV/AIDS. And we are also building a maternal health hospital with the RHRU in Vets. So we convened a workshop whereby we asked each of these partners to collaborate, instead of working independently, to collaborate into one program that is going to provide solutions for management of HIV/AIDS. That was one way of consolidating our funding, but also a way of scaling up some of the initiatives that we were already running. What came out of that workshop is that we are going to develop a series of systems that one are going to provide communications and awareness on HIV/AIDS, that are going to encourage people to come for HIV/AIDS testing, that are going to assist people who are already on treatment, and that are going to manage the health care system to make it more effective. What we are doing in that space of communication, we are using quite a number of platforms. One of them is Mixit. We are using the Young Africa Live that was presented in the morning by Gustav. We are using basic SMSs whereby we are empowering most of the organizations that work on HIV/AIDS. We are using, one of the things we have done is to geomap most of the clinics that offer HIV counseling and testing. In this one, we are also using interactive SMSing. We are asking people to opt in for a service whereby they can get their results of the CD4 count. And for those who are not yet ready for treatment, also to be able to send them reminders on when to come back for treatment. For this objective, we are using quite a number of platforms. One of them is iDART, and text for life, whereby people who are already on treatment are getting reminders on when to come for treatment and when to take their treatment when they are at home. In strengthening the healthcare system, we are also using a number of platforms in managing the stocks in the dispensaries, but also to monitor who comes in for testing, what is the profile of those people who come in for testing, and who comes back, who doesn't come back. So that is becomes part of the decision-making support that government or any other person needs. So this is all the work that we have been doing in this space. We hope that through this, we are going to be able to build a system that can provide communication, that can provide management, that can provide management of the health centers where HIV/AIDS is being administered. And it is this one system then that there is a potential of it being commercialized. It shall not only be a system for managing HIV/AIDS, but it shall be a system that could manage any other health, be it TB, be it high blood pressure, and all those things. And for that, then, there is commercial value in that system. And Vodacom now has become interested in monitoring the developments in this project with a view that it might be commercialized at some point. What we are currently doing now, we are integrating the systems that have been developed by Geomet, the Impilo system, the one that was developed by Prakelt, the one that was developed by Cell Life, into one system that will be able to do a multi-function and that can sit on a number of other platforms, depending on what platform the government will ultimately deploy. So that is where the value then of commercialization comes in. One of these systems, the one that is that has been developed by Geomed, has already been deployed in Tanzania in public hospitals at commercial rates. That means that whatever other system we are developing now has got that potential not only to be used by the private sector health system in the country, but it can be exported into other markets. This is what we hope this system is going to achieve: an improvement in adherence to treatment, an improvement in people knowing their status, an improvement in the management of the dispensaries by the various health systems. Just then to bed this discussion on commercialization, what we know is that the foundation shall not be the test bed for commercial products of Vodacom. But we also acknowledge that the foundation can be the source of ideas that ultimately can be commercialized. An idea can come because there is no technical solution, that we are looking for a technical solution, and then the foundation can pay for the proof of concept in addressing a social issue, not for a commercial need. And through that, when the tests of efficacy are done and commercial viability, this can be a product that can be sent out to the market. But also, there can be a technical solution, but with no funding. The foundation can come in and put in funding and try and see if this can stand the market. If it does not, it can just go and continue being offered as a social good. It doesn't have to be a commercial entity all the time. So this is just a recognition that social good, the social entrepreneurs, can be a source of ideas that can be developed for commercial purposes. Now, what this requires then is that there has to be a very structured engagement between Vodacom and the social entrepreneurs themselves. Because should these products come to market, there has to be a business partnership arrangement that will ensure that there are revenue sharing mechanisms in place upfront. And that arrangement will also ensure that we minimize the possibility of that social entrepreneur competing with Vodacom at some point when there's a tender. But the other lesson that we have learned through this case study is that there has to be a re-engineering of processes within Vodacom as a company. that seeks to put the foundation now in the center of the business, not as a stepchild as it has always been in the past. That now we need to be part of the strategic thinking of the business processes of Vodacom. So that at the point we know the thoughts of the thoughts of Vodacom, but also Vodacom, they get to know the projects that we are running on, and at an early stage, they start looking at the commercial value within the projects. But then that needs a very big mind shift then, and we should acknowledge that it's going to be a process. But as it is, particularly through this project, because we have benefited a lot from Vodacom. We have started to get a lot of resources from Vodacom. Once they've realized what we are doing, what that does then is that the monies that we have now are being stretched to increase the scalability of the projects we are going to. So there is a hope that, there is a movement now towards appreciating that the foundation or the social good can yield very big commercial results. But also, taking that further, it means that we need to invite the social entrepreneurs to be able then to come up with those ideas. And we'll be able to say upfront whether these ideas will only go as a social good or they'll ever be see themselves as being a commercial product. Thanks a lot.